Hi guys, so we're continuing from where we stopped in the other video. So sit back, relax, and continue watching. Thank you.
She said her hair took like 3 weeks.
After
the third week, she sent
them
an email.
Yeah.
For me, I remember very well because I had to leave. I was told to leave China because I was already graduated.
Yeah.
But I couldn't leave because my passport was in the embassy.
Okay.
And then they told me it was going to take 4 to 6 weeks, right?
Mm-hmm.
It didn't take 4 to 6 weeks though. It took almost to the 8th week. I was freaking out. I was freaking out because my school, they're already telling me, okay, your accommodation time is over, your scholarship was and
done.
I just needed to leave the environment, but I couldn't go anywhere because my passport was with the embassy. And I went online to find out if I can even if it's okay to exactly. send them an email to ask if it was okay, if I can inquire, yeah. You know, about the passport or anything.
Yeah.
And most of the things I was seeing online was like, don't ask them.
Are you serious?
Honestly. Online, I'm like, don't even bother. Some people I even saw like how do you say? I saw people they were talking about that DS took up to 3 months.
Ooh.
And I'm like, mine is just 6 weeks. Just calm down.
Just calm down.
And they didn't make any inquiries to ask for the status update or anything like that. No, they didn't. And me, I'm not be like, okay, me, I'm not too much in a hurry. Let me go and hurry them and ask them. Do not give me visa again. No, I was patient. I'm going to wait. Whenever, and just take your sweet time.
I know is
give me the visa. That's all. Because if you don't give me the visa and I'm hurrying to collect passport, and then what happens in the end? Then I already paid half of the school
fees.
Hey, no.
The thing is, I think that because people put that whole 3 week thing in my head, I started freaking out. That's why I sent that email at the end of 3 weeks. Before I sent that email, best believe, I had started googling how to appeal after a visa rejection. Because I was like, everybody got a message from all the people that like told me about the experiences.
Mm-hmm.
They got a message at the third week, by the third week, and then it was like Thursday, nothing. This third week has finished now. I just understand Google. Can you appeal after a visa rejection? What are the reasons you get rejected? I'm such an overthinker. After doing all that rubbish,
somehow they are nice to you because they asked you, okay, bring your travel document, bring your travel insurance, and they even sent you an email to tell you, okay, your visa is ready.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing like that for me.
For
I went through all my documents, travel insurance, everything, and they took everything from me.
Okay,
yes, and they didn't send me any email though, to tell me that the document was ready. The day my passport came, I was sleeping. I received a message that my core ID a parcel has come in.
Mm-hmm.
So assuming I bought clothes that period,
that
it would have been clothes.
Thing,
you know,
yeah.
I didn't even it didn't occur. I was expecting the passport, but I didn't know it was the passport that was coming. I didn't know the exact day it was coming. So I just came. I just opened my phone. Then I saw the parcel number. My mind told me that it was the
visa
because I was supposed to leave China, so I wasn't buying things.
Again,
I didn't have any extra. I just needed the passport that was coming, so I just walked. I was shaking to go to get my passport. Like, you this who rejects me? Hey,
it's finished.
Which
month? Here I come.
Which month shall I use to explain what happened? So I went. I took the passport. D and D, so that
never waste time.
So that if it's the rejection, let me stand there and start crying. No?
The earlier you cry, the better.
So I opened the parcel. I saw my passport. I checked to see if I did any rejection letter. Because normally they're going to reject you.
They'll
put this letter.
You first check through the document.
Yes.
If there's any foreign.
See anything foreign. So I opened it, it was just my passport inside. My mind came down.
Oh, they didn't take original documents.
No, they just took my photocopies.
They
took my photocopies of my school, everything, motivation letter,
all the rest.
Okay. So then now I just saw only my passport. I knew that it shall be good news. So I asked him, and I started opening, looking for the page where
the page?
My visa was.
My God.
And I saw it. And I used a fine passport.
Actually, my passport of my visa was beautiful.
I used
that same passport for my residence when I got here. So
me too.
When you see my passport, you see beauty.
Exactly.
When you see my residence, you see beauty. You be like, I can't be the ugly passport for this thing that's going to take
some. I'm telling you, you'll be like, no, this girl, she's too fine for us to reject her. You know what I'm saying?
But yeah, guys, that was like the story. So like pretty much different experiences for me. I kind of still believe that mine wasn't so intense because I heard of other people's experiences.
And
like they would ask them, tell me why. I mean, this particular program you want to study, there are a lot of universities that offer it in Nigeria. Why are you leaving Nigeria to study it in Germany? There were even situations where they asked people, so why Germany? Why not US, Canada or UK? You have to answer. Like, they would ask you different things because typically they know that a lot of Nigerians go to US, UK and Canada to study.
Yeah.
So why would you choose Germany? And Germany is not an English-speaking country. So
why would they want to go through the stress?
They would ask you this question. It depends on who you meet and the person's mood.
Exactly.
Honestly, they can drill you. Some people will just be chilled and whatnot. Then some people, you just like, did you see me in your dream? Because, ma, this thing you're saying, you're not great. Like, so literally, you don't really know who you would meet and the kind of things that they would ask you. So typically, just be prepared. Find like all possible questions that you can be asked and have like good backings to it. They can ask you after your program, what next? What do you intend to do? Don't go and say, well, I intend to stay in Germany because I heard that people will allow me to stay back.
They won't give you.
So you should be able to say something useful, like what do you want to do with this degree? Maybe I want to come back to my country, I want to give back, or I want to start a business. You should be able to say something that is tangible for them to see that this thing you are going to do in their country, it's you want to put it into good use.
So your country,
you should have
continent
like
as well.
Proper backing and everything. And if maybe your program is in German, of course you should have learned German. You should be able to speak German because I feel like they would do your whole interview in German. That lady that was doing her family reunion, they spoke to not entirely, but there were certain times they spoke to her in German and expected her to respond because. For you to do family reunion, I think you should have done A1 and A2 level or something. So they expected her to have some basic level of communication in German. So if your program is in German, of course, you should have gotten to a proper, like at least B1, B2 level in your German language course. So that, because they would ask you a lot of things in that they could literally just be speaking only German to you.
And then imagine you're speaking German to you and you have no idea what you're talking about. And then if I remember correctly, I think they even asked me if I wanted to be questioned, if I wanted to be interviewed in German or English. I think I was asked and I was like, please, English.
Can't afford to
embarrass myself.
English. But yeah, guys, that's the story. And trust me, I mean, for us, it was pretty much straightforward. Getting to this visa interview stage, believe me, it took a lot. So maybe on another video, you guys are going to see like my whole journey. I had been to that embassy like odd times, if I'm not even exaggerating, before my visa interview.
Waiting
a lot happened. Honestly, that just is one of the. But no, I was depressed. Jesus Christ. Like, they were rejecting my document. Well, we'll talk about that in another video, but it was crazy. Before I got to this point, I had gone through hell and back.
Are you serious? For me, I just went. The day I went to the embassy was the only day I went. Like, it was actually the last day I went. I didn't have any other contacts there anymore. I just went sometimes.
All I can say is thank you, Unipod. You did me. But anyways, thank you guys. If you watched to this point, thank you. This is the end of this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Tell us your own experiences in the comment section or at least what you've heard. And maybe if there's any parts of an interview process or visa interview, you know, day that you would want to know about that we didn't talk about, feel free to put it in the comment section and we would answer all of your questions.
And also, if probably you applied, maybe not from Nigeria or from China or from any other country, yeah, you can also put your experiences there. So.
Because we'd actually want to know what the different experiences are for Nigerians who apply from
different parts of the country.
You know, different countries to Germany, so we'd actually like to know.
And even if you're also not Nigerian, maybe you're from a different country that you know also requires visas coming to Germany. Just tell us your experiences.
Give us this. We're giving you our own. with all of my stupidity that I have presented my own. And we've presented our own, so we need you guys to present your own too.
Yes,
so thank
yes.
you so much for watching till the end. Don't forget to subscribe, like, share, comment. Turn on notifications.
Yes.
So you can see when we, you know, give you again.
Yeah, drop videos. Like
but yeah, anyways, that's about it. Thank you so much. And
we'll see you.